It's about Isolde Oberreiter, called Poldi, who in her 60s or when before on her 60s birthday moves to Sicily from Bavaria, from Munich, Bavaria. She's Bavarian, in order, intending to drink herself to death with a sea view. But something always comes in her way, and usually it's a murder case. And as stubborn as she is, she's trying to solve the murder case. And then she has a knack for policemen, especially one Italian detective, Vito Montana. So she falls in love, finds back some joy of life, still drinks, has a lot of fun, and she's a kind of a hippie character from the 1950s, 60s, and with an exciting life. And the whole story is narrated by her nephew from Germany, because the Italian family sends him in from Germany to pay attention to her, to dump the alcohol and make sure that she's not dying. And he's a wannabe writer trying to write a big family saga, always fails because it's a trashy shit what he's writing. And he's a nerd, embarrassed of everything, but then he tries to be a very good chronist of his aunt's adventures, and tries to be as honest and detailed as possible. So the aunt has a lot of adventures, even a lot of sex actually, because she's still enjoying that part of life. And the nephew is totally embarrassed to tell us about that, but he does. So this is, and then it's crime fiction. It's what we call it in Germany, it's cozy crime, so funny crime fiction. You might not have the term in the UK, but we call it cozy crime. When you read Antipoldi, and I told you about the narrative perspective, that everything is narrated by the nephew, you might have the idea that the nephew has something to do with the writer himself. So, and there's a little truth in it. Since like over 20 years, I wanted to write a big family saga, the story, the history of my Italian family, which starts in the late 19th century. And I never made it. I never got to grips with it. I did not have a story, no protagonist, nothing. And I always failed. And then at a certain point, I thought, okay, well, don't make it too difficult, Mario. You just write about Sicily in a genre you're familiar with, which is mystery, and make it funny probably. So why so serious? Try to make it funny. And then I had this aunt, Poldi. There was a Poldi. I had an aunt Poldi. She was Bavarian. She moved to Sicily when she was 60. She tried and made it actually to drink herself to death with a sea view. We all loved her, and she was a dramatic character, not as much as my protagonist, but she was kind of a blueprint for Poldi for me. So I moved in her abandoned house for a year in Sicily, stayed there, and started developing the series. And funnily enough, writing Antipoldi series opened me up for this family saga, and then I could write it, and it will be published in spring now.